They've been here.
I'm chilling, bro.
Man, it's gonna be crazy. It's crazy. So it's just getting them to believe like they can be the bosses in this. I'm gonna talk about that tonight. Like, operate as the leader. Just that's the discussion. And then we're gonna move into this Jordan era. So when my idea is this, when we are free to walk over, the Jordan 1 is not gonna be the original, it's vintage, it's very valuable now, people love it, and when you have a pair on, people know, like, you're rocking that. So it's kind of the same thing. If you people know, like, you bank with one of the oldest black banks in the country, it's vintage. It's,
purse.
Take one of each of
pets.
Just warning. Just, I would. Are you? I'm not saying that. I'm just saying. We don't want it. Yeah. Fast. Just want to lift this up. Just snatch that.
Second quarter, all associates meeting. We changed the name from sales rally to all associates meeting because we don't want to have a sales environment in the community bank. That's the big bank stuff. We are consultants to the community, so all associates meeting sounds more soothing and easier on the ears than sales rally. I don't want to ever talk about sales at a bank. Like, we are consultants and we move organically through the community. So today's agenda is packed with updates on how the bank's performing. We're going to talk a little bit about what's going on in retail. We got an update on the conversion. Patrick's team's here again as their third session. They're going to be talking about strength tonight. And this is a big time. We just went through conversion. And to talk about your strengths towards the end of the year as you're learning a new system is perfect timing. So they're going to spend about 30 minutes going through a handbook on this vision. You see these Jordan 1s on the table. I'm not going to steal their thunder on that. That's going to be a meaningful opportunity to engage and figure out some goals for yourself for the rest of the year. So before I get started, I wanted to make sure we did some housekeeping. First, restrooms, first-time visitors, if you need to get up and get to the restroom or grab yourself a drink, this isn't like pause and go grab something. If you need to get something to eat, feel free to get up during the meeting. It's okay. Nobody's going to throw anything at you if you get up. Also, restrooms are outside this room to the left. And so you go through those doors, look to the left, there's men's and women's rooms, just from a housekeeping standpoint. Last but not least is Elmo, okay? All right? And if this is the first time that you've seen Elmo or have heard of Elmo, he stands for a lovely acronym when you're hosting a meeting so we can all get home and rest and watch our on-demand TV, is Enough, Let's Move On. And so usually I try to put someone in charge of Elmo, so when speakers get up and get a little preachy, we can just kind of wave Elmo at them or throw Elmo at them and tell them to sit down. We're trying to get home to watch our HR on-demand. So let's see. Who wants to watch Elmo today? I think Miss Jones, would you like to watch Elmo today?
Be careful about that.
Okay, I think, you know, usually the person that holds Elmo has kind of a bold, you know, mentality, so they're not scared to tell people to sit down and let's move on and get on with the agenda. So, all right, next, our CEO is not here, and so I wanted to make sure we heard from him, so he recorded a video just kind of for the occasion, for our second quarter all associates meeting. So give me just a second. I'm going to pull up a video of Sergio, just with some comments about how he feels about how the bank's doing. Give me a second.
Here he is. I'm off the audio. Still running.
Everyone hear that?
Good evening. Welcome to our quarterly Citizens Bank TV. I'm sorry that I'm not here with you in person, but know that I'm here with you in spirit. We have a lot of exciting information to share with you. But first, I would like to extend my sincere congratulations and thank you to each and every member of our Citizens Bank team for the hard work and dedication that you have expended, enabling us to be where we are today. We are in the midst of completing one of the most important initiatives in our bank's history. That is the conversion of our core operating system. This conversion will enable us to be highly successful and competitive in a rapidly changing world of digital banking. The benefits of this conversion will be very significant for our customers, our communities, and ourselves. Despite the severe negative impact of the COVID-19 pandemic on our personal and professional lives, we have overcome the challenges we face, and we are now in the strongest financial position in our history. We have a strong capital and liquidity base, and our financial performance for the last 6 months gives us a glimpse of the bright and exciting future for Citizens Bank. I want to thank you again for all that you do for the bank and our customers. I'm very proud and privileged to be a part of the Citizens Bank and the Citizens family. So let's get started. I will now turn over the meeting to Corey and Jim.
All right. And I appreciate him taking the time to do that, and he really wanted to be here. But we do have a very special guest here, and I'm glad that he was able to take some time to spend with. He has not had a chance to be at an all-associate meeting, so our chairman of the board, Richard Manson, is here. I've asked him to come up and just address us, because we have not had a chance to hear from Brother Manson and just to hear his thoughts on how we're doing. He's been around a while, and he's seen this bank do a lot of cool things, but I think we're about to do the coolest thing ever, and he's been behind the scenes working hard to get us here. So I'll turn it over to him, and we got to do this right quick because we're on live stream, so to give some words. Oh man, okay, let me just hold this.
Let me see if I can get this position right. First of all, my name is Richard Manson, and I am the chairman of the board of Citizens Savings Bank and Trust Company. I became chairman a few years ago, but I've been on this board since 1993 and been involved with the bank even before then. I'd like to tell the story that the first loan that I got to open my business in 1975 was from Citizens Savings Bank and Trust Company. And as a result of that, I was able to work in the community, open my own law firm, and become established in this community where I wasn't even known by anybody. So that just showed you the importance of Citizens Savings Bank and Trust Company and the impact that it can have not only on our individual lives, but on every life in our community. I am convinced that if you do not have a strong financial institution in your community, you don't have a strong community. You all represent, you truly represent what is great, what is truly great in this country. You truly represent what is great in Nashville, Tennessee, from a financial institution standpoint. We have always been looked at, not as we should, as part of this community, but in a negative, counterproductive way. And we're changing that. You all are changing that. When they walk into the bank and they see the professionalism that exists with this institution and the openness that exists. Now, we aren't perfect yet, but we're striving for perfection. And we're going to get there, and we're going to get there as a result of what each one of you truly does. I saw on the website something called purpose-driven banking that is so powerful. It's powerful because if you bank with a purpose, not just because of the dollars or the money, but you're banking for a reason, it's like a purpose-driven life. You have a life that should serve a purpose. And the people that you encounter in your life should be able to share that purpose with you and support everything that you do. We're asking now for the Nashville community support our purpose. That is to provide economic growth and development for every citizen in Nashville. We're committed, strongly committed, to providing every person an opportunity to have economic freedom. So on behalf of the Board of Directors of Citizens Savings Bank, we just want to thank you for all that you've done and all that you will be doing in order to live out not only citizens' dream, but your own. So when you go to work every day, just think about the impact that you're going to have on someone's life. I often said that when I was practicing law, and I don't do much of anything now, but when I was practicing law, I would say that there is somebody that either prayed about you or asked about you before they encountered you that day. So you can do one of two things. You can smile and say good morning, how you feeling, or you completely ignore them. But you have violated maybe one of the reasons that you are here. And you can't continue in life to violate the trust that is placed in you, each one of you, in terms of accomplishing what's important to you, but's also important to others. So before Joan throws that thing at me, because it looked like she was getting ready to, I want to end. And again, I hope you all have a great session, that you learn some things. You know, we try to be very transparent at this institution, that you learn some things and that you come out of here energized and revived and making sure that truly we are going to have a renaissance. Thank you.
Appreciate it. All right, next up, wanted to make sure we shouted out the new people that have just joined our team. I think we have one here, but I want to go through each name so you'll know when you see them at the bank to show them some love. New team members since this quarter has begun. And once again, like Chairman Manchin just said, the growth, the next generation of this bank, that we're all coming on board and we're getting ready to take us to the moon. So first team member is John Hayes. He's a client relationship manager. He joined us through from an insurance background, banking background, and also some just general business. And he'll be working directly with relationships manager on the commercial team. So he's learning all the things from Laser Pro to back office policy on the commercial side. And I think he's doing well so far. Next we have Joshua Harden, who is here today. Everyone give him a round of applause since he's here. Thank you, Josh. Josh joins the mortgage team at a crucial time, and he's been working his butt off, I can tell. Jones got him going hard already, but this is a crucial hire. As we know, mortgage has been our backbone for a long time, and Jones needed help, and I think she recruited him through a relationship at Howard, and we welcome you, brother, and we got big plans for you, so thanks for being here. Next is Shelton Link, who joined us just this week. And this brother is another person in the community that went to Tennessee State that has a story of two people that worked at this bank that ran into him working for Hertz. And this is a story we all need to keep in mind as we begin to grow. When we're out in the community and people are giving us great service, we need to steal them. It's time. We need to ask, what do you do? What do you want to do for the rest of your life and career? Because I work for a company that's getting ready to boom, and what you're doing here, we could have it there. So Joan and I met Sheldon in two different experiences renting cars at Hertz, and I was like, if we ever get a chance to hire this young man, I'm gonna come back and holler. And it's probably a month later she met him. So we welcome him. So you see him at the office, he'll be an MLO processor. And once again, everything we're doing is organic. So don't feel like we're forcing something we are just moving through an organic process, but Sheldon's gonna do great for us, and I saw him studying this week. Last but not least is Marie Stewart. She'll start this Monday. She'll be a branch relationship manager working directly with Candace for the retail team. And she'll train from a universal banker and also the platform side where she'll open accounts. But really, once again, it's a Tennessee State graduate. You know, this is our community we're bringing on board to take us to the next level. And I think you guys will enjoy meeting her when she onboards on this Monday. So Man, it's exciting. I mean, you know, one quarter, four hires. I mean, I don't know when the last time we did that and was able to celebrate it, but tonight as we toast and listen to music, man, be thinking about the fact that we're heading in that direction. So next up is just a few things, and I'm going to turn it over to Patrick team, but I want to spend just a few minutes discussing what's happening around us, because I think we can get siloed in that bank. And we know we got closed doors and everybody's doing the thing, but there's a lot of movement going on in our neighborhood. And so what I wanted to do is just talk about these things and help you realize that what we're doing is prepping for these folks. They're going to be looking to us to serve them. First up is EGMC, which is the cocktail lounge that was in the, and the Slammin' Huskies team, now there's a place to go. You can have a cocktail, you can eat dinner there, but it's on Jefferson Street, and it's themed after our music, and this is a new business on Jefferson Street. They should be clients very soon. Next is the Oracle relocation coming from Southern California out of San Francisco. They're bringing 2,000 jobs to the River North development just across the river from our bank. What do you think they're going to, where are they going to bank? They're going to come right down, they're going to turn right off of Cowan Street, and they're going to come over the bridge. What's the closest community bank to them? They're going to pass Regions, they're going to pass Advanced Financial, I know, and they're going to come to that office. We got to get ready. They're going to come in droves. These folks are coming from California. They're going to want to do something cool in their neighborhood, and we're going to be number one. Next is Centric Architect is relocating from the trolley barns building next to where we went bowling at Pinewood Social. That place, you know, we went bowling, their offices are right there where General Hospital used to be. They're moving to North Nashville on Buchanan. Their building is almost done. They're also putting four of the businesses and a coffee shop in that building. That's another 100 people. Guess where they're gonna come? And we already have the relationships with these folks too, by the way. So when they get open, guess where they're coming? Citizens Bank. Next is the bakery development. I'm going to a hearing on this building. It's behind Edge Fish and Pieces, an old bakery. They're gonna have probably 40,000 square feet of office space, a gym and all this stuff, right behind Edge Fish and Pieces. It's going up with the parking lot. Guess where they're gonna want a bank? Citizens Bank. Next, Willie B's. You've heard of Willie B's. The Trenches, which is a boutique shoe store where you can get your Jordan 1s. The Trap Escape Room, where we'll do a team event one night. We'll go and try to escape the room, and it's right there by our office. Okay, this is our community. And, you know, we used to have to venture out. This is where we are. The Flash Experience, if you've been driving down Jefferson across from R&L Liquors, I can't name the liquor store right there, but right across the street, there's this odd little building that says the Flash Experience. And this is a place that you can rent out for parties and then take pictures. And it's on Jefferson Street. It just opened this year. Where are they going to bank? Where are they going to send their clients to for money? Of course, last but not least, all of our HBCUs that have always been in our backyard have had their highest amount of giving. FIS, TSU, and Meharry, their endowments are as high as they've ever been. Where's that money going to go? Citizens Bank. So what we're doing right now is not just for our existing clients. Yes, we love them and we want them to move with us. But we are building a platform that can take on this growth. That's a lot of growth for a bank. If we just capture this business in a few years, we'll blow through our goals with no problem. All right, the last statement I want to make, and I'm going to bring up Patrick, is this. What does this mean for CSB&T? As you sit in this space right now, this is the third quarter. We're going into the third quarter, and everyone's been here a while. It's been trudging through the conversion. You've been moving us past this, but you've been operating in different roles. What we've got to do from a mindset standpoint, and what Patrick is going to talk about tonight through our strengths, is go from operators to leaders. Because we're the top 25 people of this bank. And so in 5 years, if we're a $500 million bank, we'll have 100 people working here. The first 25 people should be running those departments. So if you're sitting here right now, you are not just a operator. You are a leader. So let's shift as a team from that to an entrepreneurial mindset. which means you have to open up and be more broadly thinking about everything that affects the bank. Everything. So this is our chance to do it. So next up, I want Pat to come up. Our team from Aspire is going to help us get in that mindset with our strengths to lead us from operators to leaders. And here we are. Thank you, Patrick.
That was so weak.
Thank you.
Check. Is this just a record?
I never get these recordings. I never hear them. Right.
But no, really, make some noise. That was so weak. Make some noise. Are you going to leave when it's my turn?
No.
But on a serious note, I heard some things today that are worth making noise about. Anytime I'm in a room, I remember I was in New York with my business partner, and on his wall, he had some goals. And one of his goals for 2016 was to save $500,000. And I remember thinking, if his goal was to save $500,000, how much was he making, right? And so I'm always inspired by the goals that people set out in front of you. So when I hear Jeff talk about hiring 100 more people, being worth $500 million, those are things to make noise about. For me and my company, we're excited to be in that space as we've transitioned from education to be more in the business. And so as you think about yourself and as you think about today, we're gonna talk about two things holistically. We're gonna talk about vision, your ability to actually feel, see long-term myself being a part of a $500 million bank. It sounds great to say that the people on Oracle will come down off of the river, but how do we really visualize that? How are we ready for that? How do we really position ourselves so that when you talk about banking in our city, Citizens Bank pops up, not as the Black Bank, not as the North Nashville Bank, but just as the bank. One of the things I wanted to do when I started my company at the same time with my brother who's a chef and my other brother who's a videographer. My first goal was I wanted, when you asked about speaking in Nashville, that my name came up. When you asked about authors in Nashville, my name came up. My other brother who's a chef, we wanted to make sure that if you had a wedding, if you had a banquet, if you had an event, even if you didn't book us, if you asked about a chef in our city, you wouldn't go too many places without our names coming up. Citizens Bank is in that same trajectory. So before I get into it, it's been a long day. I've had a long day. Raise your hand if you had a long day. Cool. I'm gonna bring up Christina. Get to the edge of your seat. She's gonna help us take this in and breathe for 5 minutes. I wanna give you kudos. I've seen you all over the gram lately, so you've been doing something great. Like, look at Citizens Bank. They showing love on the gram, getting sight. So y'all make some noise for Christina Rayford. She's our director of mindfulness. As she's coming, I want you to think about two things. I want you to think about vision. I want you to see yourself inside this company 5 years from now as you guys get to take the front of your seats and begin to meditate. The second thing I want you to think about is your strengths. But I want you to think about your strengths from one thing and one thing only. I want you to think about what you do better than everybody else all the time. I want you to think about who you are when no one's looking. I want you to think about what your grandmother would tell me you do well. I often laugh when I'm in these speeches. Last week I was at Clemson University. It was one of those moments in my career where I had to take a pause. I was walking around and they were showing me what 3 national championship buys at a university. And I was sitting there remembering my very first speech behind Pearl Cone when I made $25 for a retreat. And the ladies were trying to feed me beanies and weenies. And I was excited, but I was like, no. I had visions of being walked around number one football teams, being treated like getting flown out. But 8 years ago, it was literally just a vision. But I got there by doubling down on my strengths. When everything got chaotic, when I didn't know what my next move was, I knew that my ability to communicate intangible success traits would put me in a million-dollar room. So as I hear Jeff talking about $500 million, I hope y'all get it, because then I can go to U.S. Bank. Then I can go to Regions and say, well, you know, our human development workshops were part of the reason that Citizens Bank is who they are. But I say that to say, think about what you bring to that vision as you meditate over those strengths for the next 5 minutes. When I come back, we're gonna talk about how this shoe from 1984 is still the number one selling shoe in 2001. And we're gonna talk about what we do better than everybody else all the time. Give yourselves a round of applause. Thank you.
Walk to the next
trying to slow it down. Ready? Breathe it in. Take 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 it in. Breathe out. Breathe out. As much as you can. As much as you can. All you got. Bring it all you got. All you got. All you got. Last one. As much as you can. Let's try to slow this one down. Take it in. Take it in. Take it in. Breathe out. Breathe out. As much as we can. As much as we can. As much as we can. Good stuff. Good stuff. While we're still standing up, go ahead and take one shoe off. Your best balanced leg gets to keep the shoe on. The other foot is going to go up. So take one shoe off, one shoe off. Okay, this technique is a grounded technique. This happens when we spilled our coffee in the car. The kid didn't want to put on the outfit I picked out this morning. The customer just tried my entire life. Like, when we're having those kind of moments and you don't get to walk out, take a break, things like that, right where you're standing, take your shoe off, and you're just going to put the bottom of your sole of the foot onto your calf. Just starting baby steps. When you get better at it, you may be able to rise that foot up to higher, but we're just trying to find balance, and we're trying to ground ourselves again. So, and you don't have to try to balance if you can use your chair. So what we're gonna do is, the second that you're feeling that way, we just rest our foot here, and you're just gonna give yourself like a 10 count. So everyone just kind of focus on the balance, focus on what it feels like for our foot to be touching our leg, and just give yourself 10 seconds. You're gonna close your eyes, give yourself 10 seconds. And all we care about is what it feels like. All we care about is the grounding, get grounded, get grounded. Give yourself 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so that's what we do. If you are still at an irritated space, I would switch me. You need more work. Does that make sense? Breath through our nose. check. See that image? See your goal being met? After your last breath, you can go ahead and slowly open your eyes. Y'all are feeling it today. That felt good. Love it, love it, love it. Hands together, palms together, palms together. It is done. Say it with me. It is done.
It is done.
To build an empire on track and field alone, so Phil Knight turned their focus to the fastest growing sport in the country, basketball. So my question to you guys is the parallels. When I hear about basketball and Phil Knight thinking that they won't grow Nike just on track and field alone, it reminds me of Nashville. Whenever I go, I tell people, 2014, 2013, when I would travel, I would tell people where I was from. I'd be like, yo, I'm from Nashville. They'd be like, okay. Now when I'm out and I'm like, I'm from Nashville, people want to talk to me. They're like, oh my gosh. You're from where? I'll be in the Uber and the driver will be like, I'm from Nashville. I'm rare, aren't I? I'm like, no, I'm from here too. They're like, oh, I never meet people from here. But I think about what is our version of the fastest growing thing in the country? What is Nashville, what can Citizens Bank be ahead of? The other thing that I wanna look at, and this is a real question. The reason that we put these shoes in front, how many of y'all got children? How many of y'all have seen these shoes before? How many of y'all realize that this shoe that this true, I know, she like, I've been telling my babies, this shoe old as hell. Look, she been telling them, right? But how many of y'all have realized that the number one shoe in 2021 was a shoe that was first molded in 1984 for a little kid from North Carolina, that Nike banned, right? So my first question to you guys, why is this shoe still as relevant and more popular than ever? To put it in context, when this shoe came out, Nike was trading at less than a dollar a share. Last week when I looked, Nike was up at 180, right? So, two questions. Why is this shoe still relevant? And what made the company grow that way, that fast? Talk to me.
Marketing.
How many people can agree? So one of the things I tell people, if you notice, everywhere I go, I have this young man with me. When I first started my company, before I ever made any money, I was paying money to go speak because I knew that I couldn't tell somebody I gave a good speech yesterday. I couldn't go to a client and be like, hey, I promise I gave a great speech at Citizens. Trust me, I had to show them. So when we think about that, marketing is gonna be the main reason that we touch some of these visions that we talk about. One other reason why the number one shoe in 2021 is the same shoe that it was in 1984. Talk to me.
Yeah, like what the shoe represented, who was behind the shoe.
And who was that?
Michael Jordan.
So, my next question, who's gonna be your Michael Jordan? When I first started my company, I took a business plan. I went to the hoarding people right there on Broadway, and I was like, yo, I wanna pay $1,500 to get a business plan done. And the guy, he saw my eagerness, and I could think he could tell that I really didn't have the money like that, but I was ready to spend it, because I felt like that's what you're supposed to do when you start a company, you pay somebody for a business plan. So he looked at me, he was like, before I take your money, tell me a little bit about your clientele. I was like, well, I'm already working with the YMCA, Girl Scouts of America, and a couple other companies. He said, listen, man, I'm gonna tell you this. If you're already working with the YMCA, you don't need a business plan. Most people think that business is about having a lot of clients, but how many YMCAs are in the country? If one of them is giving you $3,500, what if you get that from every YMCA? I walked out, wow, thank you, right? And I just went to calling every YMCA, from the East Nashville Y to the North Nashville Y, ended up in Brentwood. That's when they had the real budget, right? And we kept going.
But to your point, as you guys grow, it could take that one client at Oracle that brings all the customers from Oracle. It takes that one elementary school teacher that talks about how you grew her $100 and helped her mortgage go further that brings all of that. So in each of your departments, who is your Michael Jordan? But the thing about Michael Jordan, it was internal and external. Nike gave their last for this young kid out of North Carolina. No one knew Michael Jordan would be Michael Jordan, not even Michael Jordan and his mama knew that in 2021, a $16 shoe from China would be retailing at $200 and reselling at $500. Every shoe on this table worn, I can go get $250 or $175 for each shoe of these, even worn, right? So how do we, as a bank, keep that same culture going forth? And then the last question, so we talked about marketing, we talked about the clientele. I heard somebody say what it represents. Somebody else said something over here. Did I hear something? And it's the name. There's been studies that show, if I take this brother, stand up for me, brother. You look like you might have had a finger roll back. Don't stand up and hit me with the Trey Songz. He just stood up, like he just smooth. This might be y'all Michael Jordan. Y'all better get this brother on the poster or something. But if we put this brother in a Nike uniform, a Reebok uniform, an Under Armour uniform, and I asked this lady to pick one person for her basketball team, research says she's gonna pick which person? The Nike. Why? Because from the beginning of time, Nike has connected themselves to winners in all sports. So subconsciously, when we see this check, we like, it could be the same person. Different headband. We tell ourselves that he's better than these two people, right? The tough part about it right now is that, thank you so much, Mike. You are now Michael Jordan, right? You put any initial you want. That seems to work for people in the middle these days, right? So when we look and we say Citizens Bank, next to the logo of U.S. Bank, next to the logo of Regions Bank, next to the logo of Bank America, how do we let people know that Citizens Bank logo represents? And the bigger question, this is a question for y'all to answer later, what do you want that to represent? In one word. When you figure out what Citizens Bank represents in one word, for me, I won't shop with Bank of America because it represents fees in one word. My experience with Bank of America is fees in one word, right? I look at my account like, oh my God, a $3 a month water station fee. Like I never knew I was paying that. But internally, what is that for Citizens Bank? All right, give yourselves a round of applause really quickly. Boom, now the meat and potatoes, right? Strengths, really quickly, we're gonna answer. You should have this worksheet in front of you. We're gonna go to this worksheet first, actually. I got like 7 minutes left. We're gonna get through this. This is actually our most popular workshop. We take this one that's not in there. Oh, you got it in the booklet. You fancy. Who got you a booklet? Well, Eli, look, you got both, right? So you should have received the link via email, but I don't see the lady up here that normally sends that, so I'm assuming y'all might not have gotten it. So when you get it, it's gonna be your homework. I need y'all to fill that out so we can get the date on today's session. If you emailed it out, if Jeff emailed it, you'll have it. This very first thing, you're going to pick four strengths. This seven list comes from a list of Forbes. Forbes says that all leaders have some combination of these seven strengths. When I say go, we're gonna read them out loud together, starting with visionary. 1, 2, 3, go. Oops, here we go. Uh-oh, you might not have gotten that sheet. Did you give them these? Oh no, you don't have these. These were on the thing, I'm sorry. I'm gonna read them to you. The first one says, when I say them, just say them back to me. Visionary. Optimistic. Decisive. Communication. Supportive. Integrity. And confidence. When you get the link, hopefully they'll resend the link out, but when you get the link, I want you to go on the link and click one of these, which one you think you are, right? She has one, so she can fill it out. But from a visionary standpoint, an optimistic standpoint, a decisive standpoint, communication, supportive, integrity, or confident. It's fine. It's in the link. They'll get it emailed to them. If I want you to ask yourself, which one of these are you the most? Because it's going to drive your leadership strategy. If you have the book, answer the question. But I need you to put it in the link so we can take the data. So it's going to tell me a lot about the cohort. The very next thing that we're doing, everybody should have this sheet. We're about to take a quick personality test. It's gonna let me know what your animal is. While you're taking it, I'm gonna come around and guess your animal. I got about an 80% accuracy rate. You're either gonna be an owl, a gorilla, a bear, a fox, or a rabbit, all right? We're gonna go through by answering these questions. Let me, when you say, when you see this worksheet, say I have it, like at church. Nobody in here go to church but me. So, really quickly, we're gonna do A together. You guys are grown and smart. Normally I'm doing this with high school or college students, so I have to walk them through each one. We don't have to do that here, but I'll do A with you, and then I'll move through them. A says, I argue with my peers and my coworkers. If that's you and you know that's something that you do, then you'll put a one. Like, yes, I'm. See, I already know what animal you are. They told on you. That's why I love this survey. I could throw this out the window. I'm gonna get yours right when I get to your paper, I promise, right? But if you know that's who you are, you argue with your peers or your coworkers, put a one. If you like me, you like, I don't mind, I don't like arguing, there ain't no point, put a five. What I ask on this survey is only put a three if you're actually in the middle. So if it's actually 50-50, if you think you might be 51 over here, give me another number because it's gonna give you a more accurate stance of who you are. Does everybody understand those quick instructions? I'm gonna read through them. Feel free to go at your own pace. And then once I get through them, we'll let you know what animals you are, all right? B, I try to reach compromise through negotiation. If that's just part of how you move, you try to compromise, you negotiate with people, give me a one. If that's something you never do, you don't compromise, you want it your way, give me a five, or one of the numbers in the middle. C, very simple. I meet the expectations of others. Someone walks in your office, they tell you the expectation, do you meet it? Or do you get a little resentful, like, I set my own expectations, right? Some people are driven by expectations, some people are turned off by them. Let me know, all right? D, I work with others to find solutions that everyone can agree with, all right? There's a type of person in the workplace that they'll go around, they'll hear everyone because they want to find solutions that work for everyone. There's another type of person that'll go straight to the boss and then tell everybody this is the way we're doing it, right? Not really solution-oriented, but direct-oriented. E, very simple. I'm firm on defending my side of the issue. F, I try to avoid conflict by being singled out. This means you have a problem with something, but you won't say it because if you say it, everybody's gonna turn around and look at you. And you rather not be looked at than have the conflict discussed. G, I uphold my solutions to problems. This means we're in a group, we have a problem, I think it's 8, you think it's 7, you're like, it's 7, let me know when you get 7. Or you like, you know, how'd you get 7? I got 8, let's talk about it. It's always two types of people. H, very simple, I compromise in order to reach solutions. Some people come in with a compromise. So, boom, I want 20,000, I'm gonna come in and say 30 so we can settle at 18 and get out of here. Some people are like, I want 30, I'm gonna come in and say 30 and we ain't leaving until we get 30. Is compromise who you are or not? All right, I want y'all to stay focused on your paper. Don't look at your coworkers because you'll tell on people, but it's always a person like this at work, right? I was an avid student like this. I feel like if you did your homework, we did our homework. Share it with me, all right? I trade important information with others to solve problems together. There's always that one person that's like, oh my gosh, you can't figure it out. Hey, now listen, this is how you do. Go to the portal, check it out. Let me know if I can help you. You're like, no. And then there's that other person that watches you like, I will go help them, but that don't got nothing to do with me. That don't got nothing to do with me. So if you're that person that has the information but really won't share it, then you like a one. Or let me know what other number that you may be. A couple more, we're done with this. I avoid discussing my differences with others. You really hate Jeff, but you keep it to yourself. Or you like, girl, meet me at lunch. We going to Panera. I got to tell you about Jeff today. And then you heard about their Panera lunch all the way at McDonald's. All right? K, I try to accommodate the wishes of my peers and my coworkers. Hey, it's cold in your office. It's my office. Oh, I'm sorry. Is that you? Or you like, oh my God, let me turn the air down. Have a seat. L, I seek to bring everyone's point of view to light to resolve a dispute. Meaning, you want to hear from everybody before you make a decision, not just your friend or the person who desks next to yours. Three more. I put forth middle positions to break a deadlock. That's for their friend that will introduce a new idea to break a deadlock. Hey, let's go left, let's go right. How about we just go down the middle? Everybody be fine, right? N, I accept recommendations of my peers and my coworkers. Don't show me your hands, but just blink your eye. How many of y'all know people that you got to tell them the opposite to get them to do something you want, right? Right? But there are some people that will just accept your recommendation. Like, hey, you know what? I posted an IG post today. Out of nowhere, somebody sends me a text with a full critique. Like, you should add hashtags and put words on your post. I think it would increase your engagement. I was like, I didn't ask you that. But I will receive that recommendation. Lastly, I avoid hard feelings by keeping disagreements with others to myself. That means you really make me sick, but if I tell you you make me sick, we'll never be able to work together again. So I'm gonna keep it to myself. If that's you, don't be moving your eyebrows up and down. You're gonna tell on yourself. If that's you, put a 1. If that's not you, put a 5, or give me another one of the other numbers in the middle. At this point, Malik is gonna come around and make sure that you're adding your numbers together at the bottom. I'm gonna come around and guess your animal. Pay attention at the bottom because the numbers aren't in order. Let me see your pen, Jay. Juan, you got an extra pen? I left mine in the car.
Pen?
Extra pen. Nobody use pens no more? Can I borrow your pen really quickly so I can guess? Thank you so much. You are, hold on, cover your paper. You are a owl rabbit. You are a owl bear. I'm gonna go you know what? I think you might got some pizzazz in you, man. You didn't fill it out yet? Okay, I'm gonna guess you. I'm gonna go, I'm taking a leap there. I might be wrong, but I'm gonna leap there. Y'all done? You done? Okay, hold on, let me get you a pen. Who finished so I can come guess? Who finished? You finished back here, ma'am? They done already told on you. It ain't it? Okay, well, I'm gonna go 50-50. Let me see. Let me get in there. Who did I not guess yet? Did I guess you yet? Are y'all still working? Still working. All right, if you can hear me clap once, that's the school teacher in me. If you can hear me clap twice. For the sake of time, I'm gonna keep going. Really quickly, to humor myself, if I got both of your animals right, stand up. If I got both of your animals right, stand up. Okay, I'll take that. If I got a animal right on your page, stand up. If I got at least one right on your page, stand up. Okay. I got both of yours right too? Ooh, I'm gonna. Cool. So, And I'm going to tell you why you thought she was a gorilla and what she actually is. We'll get there, right? So thank you. Y'all have a seat really quickly, really quickly. So because we are adults, I'm going to tell you guys the truth about these animals that I can't always say in high schools, because you're going to see these type of people come through your banks, right? So first and foremost, gorillas. If you were a gorilla, was your lowest score. That means it's your dominant style. So what I tell the kids when I'm in school is this is a personality test / conflict resolution. Your lowest animal represents how you would respond if I smacked you in your face right now. And everybody says, if you smack me, I will smack you back, until they get smacked. So Mike Tyson has a quote that says, everyone had a plan until I punched them in the face. And what he was saying was, all of that sounds good until you actually get punched in the face, right? So, boom, if gorilla was your lowest or on your paper, stand up if you're a gorilla. All right, so for the sake of time, I'm gonna read these. Gorillas, the gorillas are standing are people that value competition. Gorilla? Gorilla, okay. Gorillas are people that value competition. The people standing wake up every day and their thought is somebody has to win, somebody has to lose, and I'm not losing, right? Gorillas use a forceful or competing style. They are highly goal-oriented, and there is a huge need to win, therefore others must lose. If their decision is correct, a better decision can come without compromise. However, it may breed hostility, all right? Boom. I'll preface this by saying none of these strengths are more important than the others. Some of them are more recognized in certain arenas, but they all are needed if we're trying to have a team harmonious. When do you use a gorilla? So the people standing are most effective when conflict involves personal differences that are difficult to change and when unpopular decisions need to be made. If you need to fire somebody, Jeff, you email one of these people. Hey, you know what, Tasha, we love you. I hate to tell you, but you gotta be out at 4:30. Matter of fact, I'll help you. We love you though, right? One of these people, one of these people. All right, y'all give our gorillas a hand, give our gorillas a hand. Next, if you are a rabbit, anywhere on your paper, stand up if you are a rabbit. Rabbit, 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 no rabbits? That's okay, that's okay. Was it your lowest or your second lowest? So, where gorillas value competition, rabbits value avoidance. I always tell people, my father is a rabbit. My mother is a gorilla. My mother was a nurse my entire life, 7 to 7. So at 6:45, when my mother was calling my dad for the end of the day, if she was in gorilla mode, my dad would call home. In rabbit mode, listen, your mama tripping today. Please make sure the dishes are washed. Be doing something when she get in the house. Because when she get there, because of a true rabbit, they're trying to avoid conflict at all costs. Because they strategically saw the conflict coming. Gorillas see conflict and get adrenaline running. I wish she would, I hope she don't. Gorillas say, I wish she would. Rabbits say, I hope she don't. I'll talk to her tomorrow, all right? Thank you so much. When do you use a rabbit? When gathering information is important and when others can't more effectively resolve the problem. You send a rabbit in when the gorilla done messed up somebody's account, because the rabbit can then go in and apologize in a way that's non-confrontational, because they don't have a confrontational bone in their body. Until it's all the way extreme. Like I tell people, if you ever play with rabbits, they fun. So you get to playing around their mouth or playing with their food, then they'll bite the shit out of you and you be like, oh, you are an animal too, right? Boom, if you are a bear, stand up. Okay, cool. I knew you was a bear, I ain't gonna lie to you. You was giving me auntie vibes whole time. I just was like, she making somebody a plate right now and she don't even know it, right? Bears are accommodating people. The people standing are generally people, when they first get out of the bed, their first thought is about someone else. So as I'm guessing sessions, when I go into a session, If you are a mother, you're generally gonna have a bear thing in you, because you, as a mama, you probably ain't even waking up, but as soon as you wake up, you gotta make some cereal or something, right? Bears use a soothing or accommodating conflict style with an emphasis on goals and relationships. With an emphasis on relationships. So the bear will take the loss to fix the relationship. They want harmony, they want accommodation. The people standing are the type of people, if you go on a road trip, they'll have extra snacks. So the gorilla walks in the gas station, same rest stop. The gorilla walks in, gets his snacks. The rabbit been in the car with their snacks because they brought it with them. They don't want nobody to bother them. The bear goes in, gets their snacks, couple extras. You get down the road, the gorilla selfishly ate all his snacks. He like, man, I need a water. Here comes the bear. Well, I got an extra one. I just grabbed one and they passed it out. When do you use a bear? When maintaining relationships is important, when time is limited and harmony is valued, right? When you've blown it with a client, but they're coming in to fix it today, do not send in the gorilla because it ain't their fault ever. Do not send in the rabbit because the stakes is too high. You send in the bear because all they want is harmony, all right? Now, Jeff, pay attention. Y'all pay attention. These next people you got to watch. Thank y'all for the bears. If you're a fox, stand up. So, my natural strength is a fox. Foxes value compromise. The 2021 word for this, don't sit down. The 2020 word for this, 21 word for this is finesse, right? So my parents have a line. When I was young, my last whooping, I was probably about 15, my daddy tried to give me a whooping. And I looked at him and I was like, Dad, the punishment don't fit the crime. And we laughed so much that I got out of the whooping that day, right? Foxes use a compromising conflict management style. The concern is for goals and relationship. So earlier you said she was a gorilla. Yeah. The difference between a fox and a gorilla says, this is what I want, I don't care what you think. A fox says, this is what I want, and this is why you should be okay with it. It's the same thing in disguise, right? So the gorilla like, I'm getting this table, I don't care who is. The fox like, you know what? You should move this table over here for me. You like, you know, I think I should do that, right? And you don't even know that you did what the fox wanted you to do until it's done already. You get home like, I moved all them damn tables, right? So watch for a fox. When do you use a fox? When important complex issues leave no solution. So when you tried everything, you can't figure it out, you bring in the fox. Foxes are also people that never, ever, ever hear no. They only hear, you didn't hear me, right? So hey, can I have $100? No. Let me get 250s. No. What about 520s? No. Well, you got 100 singles. You gotta have 100 singles. You like, you know what? I done gave you $200 now, right? So. Lastly, again, gorillas value competition, rabbits value avoidance, bears value accommodation, fox value compromise. All right, y'all have a seat. Last one, if you are an owl, stand up. Stand up if you are an owl. And this is beautiful. Most of the time we do this with young people or adults, we tie it to our vision session. But you guys were already grown and you got a job, so it's not what I want to be when I grow up in here right now. You already are that kind of. But I tell people, when I go to a school, if I'm working with a principal and he's got a room full of gorillas, you're going to have a tough year. Because when them kids come in, I know what animal they coming in with. They only have one strength. And I remind them that there's only one professional in there, and it ain't the kid, right? But if I'm in a school, I'm looking for bears. I'm looking for people that are accommodating, right? In banking, in hospitals, in places where I'm a novice, I'm looking for owls, because owls value information and collaboration. A true owl is a person that does not make a decision until they have all the information. So, come here, man, because you must like me. You tell a gorilla, hey, what's up, man? I got $400, I need you to go buy me a mattress. Cool. mattress store. Here go the $400 mattress. Here go the $200 mattress. Let me get a $300 mattress. I'm going to keep 100. I'm going to holler at y'all tomorrow. That's how gorillas move through the world, right? I will commit. I need you to buy me a mattress, right? Hey, how are you? I got $400. I need you to buy me a mattress. You give the money to the owl. First place, they go, 1 second. Okay, well, I see they have $400 mattresses in 82 stores in the tri-state area, right? Boom. They go. Then they go to the store. They lay on the mattress. They color code the mattress. By the next time you hey, you got me a mattress yet? I have you narrowed down to 5 options. Soft mattresses in blue, hard mattresses in green, medium mattresses in orange. As a gorilla now, we are pissed because we thought you was at the store buying mattresses. You've been on the internet organizing mattresses for 42 days. I moved in last week. The beautiful part, when do you use an owl? When trying to gain commitment and when learning and new perspectives are important and when maintaining a relationship is important, but time has no concern, right? So if you need to get the relationship back quickly, you call the bear. Because they're going to come hug, they're going to come love, they're going to bring the water. If you need to get the relationship back from a deep standing standpoint, you call the owl. Because they come in with the depth charts, the post-it notes, the organizer, the quotes from the pictures. All right, y'all give yourselves a round of applause. So again, when you guys get home with the link, I want you to go to that link. It'll come to your email. It may already be there. But I need you to click on the first two strengths and then let us know what animal that you were, all right? Is there anybody in here that like, that animal was not me, I do not agree? What was yours? That's what you were or that's what I picked? And you don't think you are? Yeah, you're lowest. You're lowest. You are. Yeah, you're an owl and a bear. Does anybody want to know how I guess your animals? So, and Malik could tell you, I wish, where Malik at? So right here, I knew you wasn't a gorilla already, right? But if I had to put money on what animal you was on from Vegas, what animal would she be? Why? If you have glasses, you're probably an owl. 9 times out of 10. I don't tell people that, but I rock with y'all because I want y'all to be able to recognize this when people come into your bank. Even everybody has bad eyesight. Only owls go get glasses. Right? Boom. How did I know she was a fox? Because I saw her on the internet already. Foxes are people that figure out how to get yeses before they ask the question. Right? So, boom, foxes are also people that at some point in their life, they've probably been the cool person. So when I walk into a high school, that kid that think he the coolest in the back, he reminds me of myself. You are a fox. What that means is that you figured out a way how to get a yes all the way through high school. Does that mean that they don't do work? No, that means that they figured out how to maneuver through an environment, right? Yes, ma'am. Okay. Yes.
Because I think when I was younger, I was a gorilla.
Yes, my mother was too.
In a candy shop.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
But I can see how I've transformed maturing and even the circle of people I'm around and as well as when I'm at work or my social life, I'm not an athlete.
Yes. Yes.
So I mean, I think it has a lot to do with setting also. So I think you have to have enough self-awareness to know where you are and is that appropriate for what's going on right now where I am.
And that's a great point. And I tell people, I have evolved where I literally can walk in, anytime I walk into a meeting, I know what animal is walking in there with me. That's why Jeff was like, don't guess mine, you already know. But Jeff, much like myself, has been around long enough to where he, but some people, they can't divert out of their animal. We all have a cousin Terry who is a gorilla, will be a gorilla, will die a gorilla, will have kids as gorillas, right? So much so, you warn people when they come to the house, like, listen, if you get my cousin Terry on that, he on that. The other thing too, if you have four animals that are the same, What that means is based on your experience and how you deal with conflict, you have an equal bag that you can go in when the stakes get high, right? I have two. Then if this is to the point where somebody is in here and this is my life is dependent on it, my first bag, I'm gonna turn into a fox. I'm gonna try to let you know why you don't even wanna shoot me. Like, no, that's not what you came here to do, sir, right? My only other one is super, super, super aggressive, angry, angry, angry. But I never, ever, ever go there. Like, my team can probably tell you the amount of the time they've seen me, like, upset. Because when I get upset, it's no walking backwards from it for me, right? Boom. So, but people that have multiple animals, that means that in different conflict situations, so one lady may come in and cuss you out. Somebody else may come in and blame their account on you. Somebody else may come in and say you ruined their life. Based on their energy, you can give them an energy. You might can be a rabbit. You might can avoid. You might can base it off competition. You might can accommodate. But some people can't bounce from animal to animal. But when we do this assessment with you, we want you to be able to recognize the animals. So for my rabbit, we want you to know I probably avoid conflict. So today I probably need to tap into some gorilla, right? For my gorillas, I want you to know I'm probably aggressive. Today I probably don't need to be aggressive. But there will be times when it's needed. The other thing, and I'll close on this, as you're building teams, if you've got a team full of gorillas, nothing gets done. If you've got a team full of rabbits, they avoid the work. No, you do it. I'll do it. You do it. If you've got a team full of bears, you walk in, they're going to know everybody kid name. They're going to be best friends at the end of the meeting. Oh, well, how's the finance meeting? We got a pile up there, sweet.
What?
Right? If you got a team full of foxes, you will walk into that meeting and walk out with all of their work. They will sit in the meeting and figure out, well, you know what? I think if we email Jeff this, he'll do that. Sarah will do that. Cool. They'll find, and a team full of owls will organize the work for everyone. It'll be color-coded, markers, but the combination of them together is how things work, all right? And so this is my younger brother. He was always the opposite of my strength. When I ran into my first million-dollar cameraman, I called him at 17 because his strengths, he just had the, even if he didn't have a camera, how many of y'all forgot there was a camera here sometime? That's it. If I was behind the camera, you would not forget. It's just the way that I, everybody, that dude with the camera just be everywhere. But I will send pictures of you from him. He'd be like, I never knew he was right here in my face, right? That's just his natural skill set. Any questions about strength? As you connect your vision and as we grow Citizens Bank, the things that we talked about in these animals today are a light way to get you to understand how you're gonna grow by being exactly who you are and recognize exactly who's coming into your door every day. Again, there's no hierarchy in these. People will evolve, but the other thing is people are who they are. And understanding that that animal that walks into your bank, they've been that animal long before they walked into your bank. And the same thing I tell the teachers and the medical people that I work with. It's only one person that's paid to be a professional in that environment. So if they can't dig into another animal bag, it's your job to figure it out. I don't care if you have to go to the chart and be like, okay, this is a gorilla, I need to be a, but that's how we'll grow. Anything to add? Thank you, sorry about that.
Things we're working on a way to have them alongside for longer in depth
you.
Yeah.
check. All right. How many people got left? All right, 2 minutes. I think it's people at the bathroom. All right, 2 minutes. And I got to give away some money. So I want to make sure everyone's seated. All can participate. So 2 minutes.
Hello. I'm ready to go. No.
That's on file. She ready to go. Yes, exactly. I'm gonna give away $100 real quick. As soon as the pita gets back, we'll get rolling. So. I have quiz questions. Okay, here we go. So before we get started, trivia time. We got two questions, $50 each. Okay? Well, $50 gift card.
Thank you. All
right. And tell the folks that didn't make it, they didn't get a chance to win some money. All right, anybody can play. And I'm the judge, who's the fastest? Draw on these quiz questions. Can y'all hear me? You cannot hear me. Y'all can barely hear me. All right, I will scream these questions. By show of hands, who can hear me? All right, thank you. All right, here we go. Name the newest superstar player for the Titans. Oh! What's his name? Julio Jones! Is that not a fair question? Huh? You gotta take it. Authorization code is 50. That question not fair? It's like big news. Pay attention. Read your. They're all sports questions. All right, we'll poll for next time if y'all want to do less more than sports. Okay, since it's the Olympic season, we got one more Olympic question. We got two questions at the end, so none of y'all will run out of here. I capped it, so at the end we're giving out another $100 so nobody runs out the door. So this next question is an Olympic question, since we're in that season. All right, what did I say? All right. This is a good one. Who is the Olympic athlete that canceled because of her? Oh! Mr. Perry said it first. I'm sorry. It's like Family Feud. hit the button first. Simone. What's her name? A quick slide deck on some of the things that have happened post-conversion and pre, just some highs and lows. And so Anna's going to come up and drive us through that presentation. Give her a hand as she walks up. Shout out to the conversion and all the great things that have come from that. I know we worked really hard to get here. I will drive the show for you. Thank you.
Can you hear me? We converted from Fiserv to CSI on the 16th. We converted to CSI from Fiserv on the 16th. Everything now we're calling New Point instead of Navigator. Some great feedback from Stasia. Her BSA platform is called New Monitor, and she bragged about the increased efficiency that she has, and so now she has all this extra free time at work. ATM will be live on the 2nd. Is that still yes? I can say that? Great. And just also between now and then and anytime, Wells Fargo ATMs are free for customers and the bank doesn't have to pay an interchange fee, so that's great. If they're out of town, tell them to use Wells Fargo. The bank does not pay the interchange fee. So, you know, foreign ATMs are free for our customers anyway, but this way it saves the bank money. So tell them to use ATMs.
Any questions? Anybody want to share anything about conversion? Any notes? Positive feedback?
Mr. Page.
Brother Payne with the $50 gift card.
Should we elaborate on
It will be our employee portal. We'll be able to post things like policies, procedures, employee news.
It's like an internet.
Forms, you won't have to hunt on the G drive anymore. You'll just be able to go and look, here's the thing that I need. I don't have to look for it.
Awesome.
It's going to be good.
All right.
because we're moving through the agenda very quickly so we can get out of here. We won't do that yet. Corey is going to come talk about the most exciting part of the agenda is our forecast, because we're making money.
Yeah. Oh, wow. That's great. Give Corey a round of applause. That was weak. Give Corey a round of applause. All right, thank you. So look, real quick, let's talk about some real bank stuff. So when we talk about the bank, and everybody know who's had a, you know, a 5-minute conversation with me, I talk about what is the bank's commodity? I'll take you to lunch tomorrow if you know the answer to that question. What is the commodity of the bank? Money. Who said it first? Right. So money. We buy, we sell, we trade money. Period. Right? That's what we do. So let's talk about money. So we had a budget. So around October, November 2020, we came to the board. We said, based on everything that we have going on, we say, look, here's what we think we can make for 2021, right? That's the budget. Then we go through 2021, a few things happen. One, over $5.5 million in capital was received in the first 5-6 months of the year. You hear everybody talk about Wells Fargo. They put $1.6 million in the bank. That's the reason for the free ATM, right? That's why we can use their ATMs. Not only did they give us money for capital, but they also allowed our customers to use their ATMs for free, right? Not the $3 fee. I'm talking about the fee that happens on the back end that nobody knows about, all right? That's one. Why did they do that? Just based on who we are and what we do, right? So that strengthened the risk profile of the bank. Secondly, organic loan growth supported by capital. So what happens is we take that $5.5 million, right? We take that money, we invest it in the community through loans. And then from that, we can take that money, not put it in securities that earns a smaller amount of yield, and put it in loans in the community that helps folks and earn a greater amount of money. That's what we do. All right, next. So let's talk about specifics. Balance sheet changes. Based on what has happened in the bank, to be honest, I really don't need this. So let me tell you specifically what happened. We got $5.6 million from four banks: Apex, Wells Fargo, First Horizon, Bank of America. They put $5.6 million in Citizens Bank, right? We took that $5.6 million and we paid for things like CSI conversion, right? That's what that money went specifically for. So when you saw Stacia give the quote to say, I can do my job 50% faster, that's what the money went towards. If everybody in this room can say, I can do my job 50% faster, that's efficiency. And that's what we're trying to accomplish. Not only with the products and services, but we want to do it faster, right? Second, we said, okay, 12, 13, 14 months ago, when we made the decision to move from Fiserv to CSI, it was a hard choice. A lot of people did not want to do it. One of the main drivers, other than customer service, was money, right? Listen to what I'm about to tell you. This is really, really important. Fiserv, don't put this on the internet, but Fiserv charged us over $3 million over the past 5 years for the services they provided us. When we converted to CSI, for the next 7 years, it's only $1.8 million. That's called savings immediately. Not only that, the second thing they did was, we're going to give you, don't quote me on this number, we're going to give you approximately $400,000 worth of credits that you can use however you want. So we've been sitting back wondering, how can we use it? 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 They just came back and recently said, well, one of the ways you can use it is you can credit the bill. That $1.8 million over 5 years, you know, is divided monthly over 7 years. So with that being said, we said, wow, that's a lot of savings. Let's go back and relook our budget. And then let's say our budget said we were going to make this. But based on that savings, let's go do a reforecast and let's see what we might actually make for 2021. When we did that, expenses went down, revenue went up, because remember, that $5.6 million, we used it for something. We used it for two main things. Not only residential mortgage loans, right? We also cut a deal with a company called BHG, Bankers Healthcare Group, $5 million worth of loans. We cut another deal, First Horizon. They actually put some capital in the bank. And the second thing they did was they partnered with us and said, look, we have a book of loans on our books, on our assets, on our balance sheet, we want y'all to take a part of. We bought $5 million worth of those. That's $10 million worth of loans, right? And approximately through that $400,000 credit, approximately $25,000 worth of savings. That makes sense? More loans, less expenses. More net income. So we did it. So we said, based on what we thought we were going to do, roughly $530,000. That's what we thought. When we put those three major things and four major things in the forecast and said, let's redo our budget for the last 5 months of the year. I'm going to talk like we're in August right now. For the last 5 months of the year, when we redid it, it showed $740,000 in net income. Let me explain to you guys what that means. The best way I can put it is this. Everybody knows in this room, we were under a consent order. We were under a consent order because in 2016, we lost $600,000. In 2017, we lost $3 million. So collectively, in 2 years, we lost $3.6 million. That makes sense? That's pretty bad. Then COVID happened. Before COVID happened, a tornado came through and knocked down pretty much every building in our community except for the bank, right? With all that being said, we're potentially showing a profit of $750,000. Now let me explain this in really, really layman terms. When was the bank founded? 1904. It's what? What year is today? How many years is that in between? 117 years. Let me break it down like this. In 117 years of this bank's existence, we have never made $740,000 ever. Ever. So, what I'm saying is this. Everybody in this room, you should applaud yourself because you are part of history. Thank you, Stacey. This is the most money this bank potentially has ever made. And you remember when we talked last quarter about this cash incentive? Remember we talked about that? That means at the end of the year, we hit this number. We're going to sit everybody in the room like this. But at the end of the presentation, we're going to pull some envelopes out. And we're going to hand the envelope to everybody in this room. No matter what you do, no matter what your title, right? No matter how many hours you work, we're going to give everybody a piece of the pie. Right? But that's just the start of this thing. That's just the start of this thing. I look at this like a head start. So you heard everybody talking about, you know, when Jeff did the presentation about all the businesses that are coming to 37208, this, that, and the third. The way I can sum this up, I was talking to the CEO Pathway Lending. He called me one day, and he said this. We were talking, and he ended the conversation like this. He said, Corey, the community is watching y'all. and they rooting for y'all. And we want to see what happens. I've had that conversation so many times with so many people. If we do this right, I set some people down in the room 12 months ago when we decided to do this conversion thing, and I said it was gonna be hard. It's gonna be some bumps, it's gonna be some bruises. But I guarantee you this, at the end of the road, when we look around the corner, over the mountain, however you wanna call it, we will win. I guarantee you that. With all the things that have happened to this bank within the last 3 to 5 years, there is no way we should be standing in the position that we're in right now. So now we just have a head start to capitalize on what we've done and move forward. What's next? I don't even know what's next. What's next? Is that it? So based on that, this is just numbers. I've already told you these numbers. The balance sheet has increased. The income statement has increased. And we have some more exciting news. We have announced to some, but now to all, we're gonna add some new additions to the family. Everybody knows about Marlene and Deb and the HR folks, right? But one of the keys to the CSI thing and one of the keys to performing efficiently like we need to be, we got two things we gotta conquer. One is IT. Right? And one is marketing and branding. We got to let people know who we are, what we do, and why it's important to be with us. The second thing, like I said, is IT. Everybody knows Greg Page. Give Greg Page a round of applause, by the way. For the last, I don't know however many years, Greg been running around with like a chicken with his head cut off, right? So what we said was, to get this bank where it needs to be, from a financial standpoint, Greg needs some help. Everybody understands that, right? So we said, one of the main things we said was, we are going to find Gregory Page some help. Even though, even when I come in the building and I ask Greg for something, he's grumpy with me just like he's grumpy with y'all. All right? It's just Greg Page, but we still love him for that. But we went out, we searched, we talked to folks. But the difference is with this bank is, we don't want handouts. We don't want people giving us support like it's charity. We will turn that down 100% every single time. But actually, out just outside them double doors, I met this guy. His name was Milton Bradley. And he owns this company called ImageQuest. And this company is a little different from any IT company if I've ever met. This company supports banks and other businesses, but they do it in a very unique way where you partner with them, not on a contractual basis, but on a partnership basis. Like they're in the building, like they're here, like they're one of us, right? If you guys do not know, that man is sitting right there. So I want to give him 1 minute to get up and tell you guys what is coming down the pipe, all right? Some of you guys have had some interactions with him, and he's good at what he does, right? But what we're here to do now is say, look, Paige, we appreciate everything you've done. We know you need some help. We know you've been begging for some help. We have went out and found you some help. Milton Bradley.
Thank you, friend.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Well, good evening. I know most of you. I've bowled with some of you. I've thrown cornhole with some of you. And I've rolled up my sleeves and worked hard with some of you. And actually, that's not really fair because you guys worked a lot harder than I did on this conversion. But I just want to say my role here is to come in and make Greg Page look like the hero we already know he is. And my role is to come in here and take the things off of his plate that keep him from being able to do the strategic job that we want him to do in IT. And help him not put Band-Aids on things because that's the only thing he has time to do, but we're gonna actually do some major surgery on some things and we're gonna fix them and we're gonna take this thing to the next level. So you guys will get to know me, you get to ask me questions, you get to spend some time with me. I do this for banks all over the country. I live right here in Nashville, Tennessee. I'm proud to be a part of this team, proud that Corey and Jeff and the rest of you guys have trusted me with this. we're going to have a lot of fun doing it. So, again, thanks so much, Corey.
Thank you. Absolutely. So with that being said, we got some more, a lot more actually, but we're not going to give you all to you today. We got some more nuggets coming, but it's an exciting time for Citizens Bank. But right now, I'm just going to open up. I don't care what the question is. I don't care what the question might pertain to. We're going to take the last 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes, and I'll open up to any question. Remember, I believe I heard somebody say, we're a transparent bank. You want to know something? Here's your opportunity. Ask the question. I'm all ears. The floor is you guys. Anything. Anything. Y'all must be really ready to go. So, thank you. Any questions? So let me do a lot. You got any questions, Ansley? Higgins. Harris. Harden. Fleming. Lisa? Allen? Uh-oh. Hold on. Uh-oh. So, he said, how big can we make this thing? I think I answered that question at the last quarterly meeting. Here's the goal, and we're not stopping until we get it. In 10 years, we will be a $1 billion bank. And in, what is this, 2021? When I stand up here, if we're in the same facility, in 2026, we'll be a $500 million bank. I guarantee you. Right? Anybody else? Oh, let me go around the room. Nothing. Nothing. You sure, Paige? You know you'll call me later on. My lady? Nothing. All right. Katrina? No. Bartender? You good? Nothing. All right. Well, with that being said, let's do the hot wash real quick. I've never done this before. Let me do this real quick. I've never done this before. Have we been on time? So for anybody who's new to the meeting, the hot wash is we got 4 questions that we ask at the end of every meeting to make sure, you know, the meeting ran accordingly, other than Mr. Elmo there. But on time and fully present. Station, were we on time and were we fully present? Okay, so she said, let's go. Let's hurry up. Next question, open and honest. Josh, in your opinion, did everybody that stand up today, were they open and were they honest? I would say so is what he said. What did we miss? Let me go to a old timer. Greg Page, what did we miss? Stacia said you got like 12 minutes. We didn't miss nothing? Nothing you want to add to the agenda? You good to go? You happy? So tomorrow you're going to come in, no grumpy Page. I got you. I understand that. Everybody give Greg applause for not being grumpy tomorrow. And last but not least, Elmo, Ms. Joan Fleming. Yes, sir. Did you have to Elmo anybody in this room today? Everybody spoke, gave great information. They were on time and they did not drag on. So with that being said, everybody in this room, give yourself a round of applause. What we are going to do next time, this invitation for the next quarterly meeting, our goal, forget this information, I could really care about any of this. Our number one goal is to get 100% participation. And when I say 100% participation, I don't care if you're the janitor, I don't care if you're the president. I don't care if you're the newest board member or the oldest board member. This don't work unless everybody, a part of Citizens Bank, is in the building, in the room at the same time. Right? That is what we're going to push starting Monday. The invite is going out. There is no reason to not clear your calendar. We're going to give you a 90-day heads up, right? And when, mark our words on this, since you're here, if board members don't show up, we're gonna make sure the board members know they didn't show up. if other employees didn't show up. You know, we always get on people when, no, they don't take a test, or they don't do this kind of training. But when it's happy fun time, they don't show up for that either. Please, absolutely. So that's what we're gonna do. So we are, I consider ourselves not to be successful. I don't care how much money we make until we all come together as one team. Until we come together as one team, I don't care what the numbers say, we're not successful. So the next meeting is in, what is it, October, November? November. We need 100% participation from anybody affiliated with Citizens Bank. We got 90 days. Yeah, well, in October. We got 90 days. We gonna find a way to get them here. Now y'all got questions. Go ahead. Whatever we need to figure out, we'll figure out. It was a time, like the time. So you mean I'm assuming after work, right? Yeah, whatever. Well, 6 to 7 might be tight. That might be tight. Yeah, that might be tight. You know, so what I'm saying is, we're trying to keep it, we don't want to take up people's weekends, right? Because if we take up the weekend, then that's another issue. So what we're trying is give you enough preparation and time ahead of time to do whatever you need to do to take care of family and whatever, because all we want is about an hour and a half. That's all we want. But this time, I guarantee you this, you will have a notice 90 days in advance. So please do whatever you need to do before that 90 days comes forward, right? And then everybody show up. Encourage your teammates that you know have never been here. Tell them to show up, all right? It's only gonna get better and better and better from here. Anything else? All minds clear? Thank you for coming out. Y'all have a good night.